In less than an hour, New South Wales will throw off the shackles of one of the most crippling COVID restrictions. Close contacts will no longer have to isolate for a week, and retailers in particular are already celebrating.
For New South Wales businesses, it's time to toast the scrapping of close contact isolation rules.
It's just been so hard on us because if one person gets sick, we're down. It's only three of us in the store, so it's really cause for celebration.
From 6 p.m, household contacts of a positive case no longer need to isolate as long as they're symptom-free. They still can't visit aged and disability care, hospitals and prisons without an exemption, must tell their employer and do daily RATs for 7 days. But after horror staff shortages gripped the country, this is the big step forward many needed. In February, in retail alone, there were almost 30,000 workers out.
Well, staff shortages have been absolutely crippling for the retail industry, so the lifting of close isolation regulations will make a significant difference to getting people back to work. They'll certainly be celebrating this evening.
But as we open up, an old enemy is back.
So I had COVID, got out of isolation, and then just got hit by the flu, and it was worse than COVID ever was.
Flu is definitely on the increase. It's been coming in for the last 2 months with people on planes, and we went from tens to hundreds, and we now have thousands of cases.
COVID too is taking a greater toll since restrictions eased. In the past 4 months alone, 4,500 Australians have died from COVID, whereas in the previous 2 years, 2,200 succumbed. You can now get your COVID and flu jabs at the same time.
But they can be done efficiently and effectively and safely together.
Ali Donaldson for 10 News First.